What is the most common way of pursuing your goals? Why does this excitement fizzle out? In this episode, we're going to cover exactly that. Like, why does the excitement of pursuing your goals fizzle out and what you can do about it? Episode of the Actionables podcast. If you're a returning viewer or a listener, thank you for tuning back in. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Peyton. If you're looking to pursue and reach your life goals, that's what this channel can help you do. And we bring you fresh weekly content every Saturday. And with that, let's get into this one. So let's start off by going down memory lane to about a time when you were roughly about 6, 7. Do you remember the time when you wanted a shiny new toy? And how you bugged your parents to get it, and they finally caved in and bought it for you? I think I remember personally when I wanted a video game, you know, the one which had Contra, Duck Hunt, and Mario. I remember not eating for half a day, and my dad got it for me. Yes, you can say I was a bit spoiled back then. So what happened? For some time, that shiny new toy was your entire world. You played with it, and finally, you got bored of it. Now, I know this might sound a bit exaggerated, but you get the point that anything new in our life, we are extremely excited about. But after some time, that excitement is bound to go because that new thing will soon become old and familiar. I think that is where the quote comes from. Familiarity breeds contempt. This is how our mind works. We are always constantly looking for that new shiny thing. If you're wondering how this analogy ties in with your goals, this is how. When it comes to pursuing your goals, it is extremely easy to become excited about that goal. When you start to take action toward it is when you realize that it is going to be extremely difficult. But things start getting complicated when you start hitting challenges. And soon you find that what started off as an exciting thought now has become a full-blown chore, and you find it extremely difficult to pursue your goals. Now, if this has got you all feeling dark and gloomy, snap out of it, because there is good news. And what is that? Well, even though this might be a common way of pursuing goals, it doesn't have to be like this. There is a better and a simpler way of pursuing goals, and which is what we're talking about in this episode. The trick is to know that the excitement of whatever you're trying to pursue is going to fizzle out eventually. But if you learn to be prepared for it, you will be better off. So before we get into it, as always, I want to know if you have personally experienced this excitement of your own pursuit toward your goals fizzling out and how you have been dealing with it. Leave me a comment below. I'll be sure to give a shout out to the most thoughtful comments in our next video. So let's break this into two parts. First is, let's talk about how to sustain your excitement while pursuing your goals. And second, let's look at some of the practical things that you can do when you start to notice that your excitement is fizzling out. Sounds good? Let's get into it. So part one is how to sustain your excitement toward your goals. Now for this, let me give you a relationship insight. Any person, or rather any couple who has been in a long-term relationship, will tell you that the secret to making the relationship last is that both partners do not make the mistake of taking the other for granted. So what this means is both partners are committed to making the relationship work. So how does this tie in with your goals? Drawing a parallel from this relationship insight for your goals is, think of yourself as being in a relationship with your goals. And even though you may not feel the same excitement as you did toward your goals on day one, continue to keep putting in effort. Because that's what you would do in a relationship. You wouldn't bolt on your partner simply because you're facing challenges, will you? So why would you do that to your goals? Understand that it is natural that you will not feel as excited about your goals as you did on day one. Remind yourself of the reason why you started in the first place, and that challenges are simply part of the journey. The only thing that you are responsible for are your actions. The challenges are going to remain in some shape or form. It is completely up to you what you choose to do in the face of those challenges. And the second part What practical steps can you take when you start to notice your excitement fizzling out? First is learn to take a break. Find a way that really works for you. So you may choose to turn off your phone, get away from people, and it is so easy to do that right now. Check out this video over here, which tells you exactly what ways you can use to get out of a bad mood. It is extremely critical to know when you need to take a break and when you need to de-stress, unwind, and recharge your batteries. The second is keep going back to why you started pursuing this goal. This whole process of pursuing your goals should really warm your heart. If it's not doing that for you, then maybe it's time to change. Now, what this means is if you honestly are finding it a struggle to pursue this goal, there is absolutely no shame in giving it up or changing your goal. Let go of any assumed notion of failure. You have to ask yourself whether it is simply a matter of taking a couple of breaks and recharging your batteries and getting on with it, or if you really need to give up on this particular goal. And the way to do this is you've got to decide and be honest with yourself and ask yourself, why did you start pursuing this in the first place? And the third thing to do is create an interesting way to take action. So with whatever you are trying to achieve, obviously you have to take specific action toward that specific goal. So for that, it means you need to take action. And what better way to take action than to find a routine or find a way that makes it fun? Before bringing this fully finished video to you guys, this is how the process looks. It requires me to sit down, do some research, write my script, try to edit it and present it in a better way. Now, there are two ways I can go about doing this. If I think of it as a chore, it becomes extremely difficult for me to show up and create this video. However, I have figured out a way that works for me. So the way I do it is I've learned to write on certain days in a certain place while playing certain music and really enjoying the process of creating. If I were to choose to be stressed out about it, it would show in my final product. I would not be happy presenting it. So the point being, how can you make this interesting? How can you make this fun and enjoyable for yourself? There are no rules here. Only rules are what works for you. So to wrap this episode up, I want to reiterate and remind you that your excitement toward whatever you're trying to pursue is going to eventually fade. But it is completely up to you to sustain that from happening and to make sure you take practical steps from keeping your excitement from fizzling out. It is 100% a choice that you need to make for yourself. So if this episode resonated with you, don't forget to like it and share it with a friend, and I will see you next week. If you want further coaching tips to move toward your goals, then don't forget to subscribe to our mailing list, which is called One Thing to Help You, which is a weekly newsletter. You can register, the link is mentioned in the description below. And before I go, don't forget, what you want matters, and it's really up to you to make it happen. Stay happy.